Hello everyone, I am Dr. Nidhi Gupta, faculty of BBA department from Technion Institute of Advanced Studies. Today, I am going to deliver the lecture on the concept of group and group dynamics, which is part of the subject organizational behavior. So let's begin with the concept of group and group dynamics. Basically, it contains two terms, group and dynamics. Group means two or more persons, and dynamics is equal to force. Basically, group dynamics describes how a group should be organized and operated. This includes democratic leadership in the organization, participation and cooperation among the workers. Group dynamics is viewed from the internal nature of the group, their formation, structure and the processes. And, you know, if we have to define the group dynamics, we may say this is the social process by which people interact face to face in small groups, that is called group dynamics. Now let's discuss the concept of group. Number one, we may say group is defined as consisting of individuals who perceive the existence of a group and their membership in it. Second is, we may define the group on the basis of a common motivation or the goal or the objectives. Third, the group is two or more persons who are interacting with one another in such a manner that each person influences and influenced by each other. So, members should be aware that they are part of a group and perceive themselves as such. Now, we need to discuss the types of the groups. Analytical classifications of the group may be the informal and the formal groups, primary and the secondary groups, command and task group, and in-group and out-group. Each type has different features and different effects on its participants. So let's discuss the features of each group. Number one is formal and informal groups. These are basically classified on the basis of the structure of these groups. So, what the formal groups are? They are created and maintained to fulfill specific needs or tasks which are related to the total organizational mission. They are consciously and deliberately created. That's why they are known as formal groups. They have a particular set of objectives to be achieved, like board of directors, management committees. And what are informal groups? They are created because of the social and psychological forces operating at workplace. The members of these groups create these groups for their own satisfaction. They are not regulated by the organizational rules and regulations, like the friends at the workplace. Now, if we need to discuss the attributes or the characteristics of the formal organization or the groups, these are built on four main pillars. Number one is division of labor. The second is the structure of that group. Then the functional process, number three. And the number four is span of control. And the few features of these formal groups are, first, organizational structure designed by the top management. The structure is based on the division of the labor. The people of the groups are placed in a particular hierarchy. Coordination and control among all the members are as per rules and procedures defined. Now let's discuss the characteristics or features of the informal groups. First is, they are not designed or planned. Second one, they are created on the basis of similarity like age, personality, liking and disliking, caste of the people, place or origin of those persons. Third one is, the membership of these groups is voluntary. Fourth, the behavior is coordinated and controlled by the group norms and not by the organizational rules. Second type of group is primary and the secondary groups. What the primary group is? It is characterized by the intimate or face-to-face association and cooperation. The membership is small and is based on intimate relationship like families, friendship group, neighborhood groups. While the secondary group is formal, general and remote. the members of this group may not have any interest in the problems and the pleasure of others. Command and task group. These are basically again the formal groups. In command groups, subordinates report directly to the common superior. Example, principal and teachers, manager and his subordinates. While the task group is comprised of the employee who work together to complete a particular task or project or to save or to resolve that a particular problem. The last type of group is in-group and out-groups. Cluster of individuals having dominance or the majority places in social functioning, while out-group is looked up as subordinates or marginal in the society, that means the minority group. So majorly the in-group, I mean to say the dominant people, and out-group the submissive people or those who belong to a minority group. So these are the types of groups. I hope you understand the topic. Thank you so much.